Ask and you receive, universe. The crossover we've all wanted ever since both shows have started is finally happening. So let's talk about it here on Comic Universe. I'm back. What's up, universe, and welcome back to the world's first must-see comic and nerd culture show. Welcome to the Comic Universe. I'm Dr. J. I've got a PhD in nerd culture, a nice vacation tan, and I should know, I'm printing out myself. I messed up my own intro, a little rusty, but it's all good because I am fresh, I am relaxed, I am back from vacation, and we are back to some big, big news, you guys. Okay, so as you guys know, I am the resident, like, TV guru for the channel. I watch a lot, if not all, of the superhero related shows, especially the big ones for Marvel, for DC, for Image. You know, if it was based on a comic book and turned into a TV show, more than likely I've seen it, or at least, you know, heard about it. And Runaways and Cloak and Dagger are two of my favorite shows. Runaways was a comic that I read back in the day that I absolutely loved, and I still love to this day. I have such a strong connection and bond with those characters, and when that show first came out, it blew me away with how faithful a portrayal this show gave, and the changes that it made to certain characters made a lot of sense, and I really enjoyed season one. Season two, they kicked it up even further. I really enjoyed, you know, the progression with the powers, the different dynamics with the kids, and you could really tell they upped the budget here. One thing that I did not like was, you know, they, you know, dragged a couple things out a little bit, and, you know, the change to binge format, I kind of, you know, miss weekly episode releases, but that's kind of just a TV preference more than a complaint towards the show itself. Now, you want to talk about good weekly superhero TV, let's talk about Cloak and Dagger. Cloak and Dagger was such a huge surprise because Cloak and Dagger are two characters, let's be frankly honest here, no one really cares about. Like, they're D-list at best, you know, maybe even lower. No one really knows that much about Cloak and Dagger. No one really cares, like I said. But when this show came out, man, was it good. The lore, the effects, the acting, just the setup. And now that we are fully embracing magic in the MCU, I think Cloak and Dagger will fit so nicely. And, you know, the CW has been killing it with the crossovers. I've loved all of the crossovers, and Crisis on Infinite Earths is about to be the biggest one yet. And so now Marvel is finally throwing their hat into the ring, and they're, you know, starting off small, but this is the first huge step into, like, crossover TV territory. I know what you guys are thinking. Jay, what are you talking about? They had the Defenders. You know, that was a big crossover. Yeah, no, it wasn't. It was just a feeble, really poor attempt. Let's be honest. Now that you can look back at Defenders, it was not that good. They didn't really put effort into it. They didn't really try. But this, since this is smaller scale, I think this has the potential to be awesome, okay? And it makes perfect sense with this world. Now, like, Luke, Danny, and Jessica, they all have interacted naturally, right? And I mean, you know, Matt is also a street-level hero, but with Defenders, it felt like they were forcing each other to be a part of their stories. However, Cloak and Dagger can fit naturally into the Runaway story without feeling forced. Because if you've been paying attention to the news, you know that Runaways Season 3 is going to be focusing on more magic stuff, and one of the main antagonists, actually the main antagonist, is going to be none other than the Ancient Witch of Camelot herself, Morgana Le Fay. Yeah, folks, we're going way deep into magic territory, and I'm hoping this means more magic stuff for Nico, because Nico's my favorite character, and I love all the magic stuff, and her exploring her mystical heritage, and all that other amazing, like, source material from the comics, her training with Doctor Strange, doing all this other crazy stuff. Oh my god, so many doors are opening. And like I said before, Cloak and Dagger already kind of cracked that door open with their series, talking about like the Loa and different sources of magic. And just like with Runaways, it's kind of this weird hodgepodge hybrid of science and magic. In this case, like a scientific experiment triggered kind of a magical phenomena. And, you know, that's sort of the case also with Nico and her powers. And I'm hoping, you know, with that, we'll get to learn more about, like, the magical side of the MCU. Because, you know, of course, Doctor Strange has been announced for, you know, Phase 4 and stuff. So I think having the TV stuff to supplement it is going to be really cool. I know a lot of people just don't pay attention to the Marvel TV as much because it's not as, like, prominent as the, you know, Arrowverse stuff. But Marvel TV has been killing it, you guys. And I cannot wait to see this because, you know, even in the original Brian K. Vaughan run, you know, Cloak and Dagger played a small role in there. And I think, you know, it's a nice homage to that, you know, original source. And at the same time, it works out because, you know, slight spoiler for the end of Cloak and Dagger Season 2. But Ty and Tandy have decided that they're going to, you know, start traveling around and helping people. They're going to go outside of the city of New Orleans. They're going to leave the Big Easy and check things out. So, you know, maybe they end up going to LA, and, you know, it's not even a maybe. We know they're going to end up going to LA, and that's when we're going to run into our group of runaways. And of course, Ty and Tandy are no strangers to dealing with runaways and, you know, teenagers who, you know, have had to fend for themselves. And I think, you know, the two of them can really bond with our group of misfit heroes really well. I'm very curious to see, like, with Runaways, though, like, they still have to finish off the whole alien subplot that they didn't tie up at the end of Season 2. I wonder how we're gonna transition from that little alien invasion thing to magic. It's gonna be interesting to see, but I'm hoping if this works out and is successful, that maybe in Cloak and Dagger Season 3, we'll kind of get a, like, quid pro quo type thing. You know, you scratch my back, I scratch yours. Like, once Cloak and Dagger Season 3 comes around, maybe the Runaways can show up there. Now, I know it's sort of a quote-unquote downgrade because, you know, Cloak and Dagger is on Freeform, which is a cable network, and, you know, Hulu is a premium streaming service, but I think they'd be down. I think it would be pretty freaking awesome to see the Runaways show up in Cloak and Dagger, especially if, because Cloak and Dagger show up in the Runaways, maybe they're in LA for an extended period of time, and that's why, you know, the Runaways end up showing up in Cloak and Dagger Season 3. I think it would be pretty awesome. Personally, I think Tyrone and Alex would make really good friends because, you know, they're both kind of the, you know, smart kid who some people expect to go, like, the hood route, and they have those, like, you know, hood connections, but, you know, they don't fit in either world, and I think it's really cool. I think, you know, those two could make really good friends. I think seeing Tandy and Carolina interact will be awesome, because Tandy is, like, Carolina, if Carolina was a little bit more emo, and, like, angry and aggressive. Carolina's very, like, happy, positive, bubbly, like, ray of sunshine, quite literally. And you got Tandy, who also has light powers, but she's much more jaded and, like, shaped by the world. And, you know, obviously with the events of Runaway Season 2, Carolina will be more jaded as well. And I feel like, you know, that will reflect in her in the next season. But I think it'll be awesome, because, you know, both of them have light powers, both of them are blonde, like, you know, affluent rich white girls. I mean, you know, it's questionable if the Bowen family was rich because, you know, he was a very prominent scientist, but it didn't really look like they were that well off. But you know what I mean? I think it'll be really cool, like, interaction fodder. Molly is gonna freak out seeing their awesome powers, and of course, I want to see how they react to the dinosaur. Just all in all, I'm just super hyped by this. If you can't already tell, like, this is definitely great news to come home to and report straight to you guys. But let me know all your thoughts and feels about this big piece of news. What are you guys looking forward to with the Cloak and Dagger Runaways crossover? And what other properties do you want to see crossover? Like the Disney Plus stuff? Or, like, you know, the possibilities are endless here, people. Let me know all your thoughts and feels in the comments down below. As always, don't forget to leave this video a like to let you know you enjoyed it. And also, be sure to hit that subscribe button and notification bell so you get notified every time myself, DPZ, or C-Dubs uploads a new video, and you'll become one of Earth's mightiest subscribers, and we really appreciate every single one of you who joined the universe. In the outro card, I will leave linked a video YouTube Mysterious Algorithm thinks you might like, as well as our latest upload, so you can check out what we have to offer here on the channel if you're new here. But until next time, guys, this is Jay from Your Stage of Views, and like I always say, once a comic geek, always a comic geek, and once a Cloak & Dagger fan, always a Cloak & Dagger fan, and also, once a Runaways fan, always a Runaways fan. Until next time, I'll catch you guys later. Peace. I'll see you in the universe.